Hey guys, I'm Kate. Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to be doing something a little bit different, where this is going to be half a chatty video and half a kind of plan with me video, where you'll see my notebook, but also like some behind the scenes stats on things. Yeah, so I'd really been wanting to chat about 3-year planning because it's been on my mind a lot recently as I've been attempting to make one for myself, and also I just constantly get the questions like, do you write full time? How do you do that? What are your publishing plans? How do you make money? Etc. So, here we are. First up, I printed out this Passion Planner roadmap. It's so super handy, and they have free printouts online, so they have other printouts you can do too. And as I was kind of looking at my goals, I was trying to think of how I could break them down so that I can achieve them, because that's really what 3-year planning or multi-year planning is all about, at least to me. Figuring out exactly where I want to be in X amount of time, and then kind of backtracking that to figure out what I need to be doing today in order to make that a reality. Like, you can't become a movie star one day if you don't go out on auditions, and you need basically like X number of auditions to like book one gig, that kind of thing. Also, growing up, I have constantly been terrible about having this dream world idea of things and easily getting sucked into this sort of fantasy or daydream. I've gotten more realistic as I've gotten older, and I've been a lot better about putting things into practice, but it's still really easy for me to slip into like imagining what could be, and then spending the time on that rather than actually doing the work. But my brain also loves organization, so let's organize. With my roadmap, the big things on my dream goals or my lifetime goals, you know, the crazy things that you hope might happen one day in those wildest dreams and fantasies you have. I want to be paid to travel. I want to hit some kind of book list, whether that's for like critical success or commercial success. And I'd love to have enough money to own my dream home, which basically just means having like a library room. Just a room full of books in my house. But only books. Not like this, where there's still a lot of books, but also a bed and a desk and whatever else. It's these kind of ridiculous things, but we're shooting for the stars here. So working backwards from that, my 3-year and 1-year and 3-month goals are a little bit more realistic, including publishing plans and specific countries I want to travel to, and of course, monetary goals, which is what we're going to be focusing on today. Now, during my recent Q&A writing vlog, I talked about how I don't want to make income solely from my books. Like, I want to have a more spread out approach to my income, multiple streams of income, just because I don't want to be reliant on any one thing, and just to diversify myself. Basically, I figure this gives me the best shot at being able to work for myself forever, or for as long as I want to. So right now there's a few ways that I make money. One, writing not novels, mostly for others and typically nonfiction. Two, YouTube. Three, Patreon. And going forward, even including this year, but not like today as of May, whatever. What day are we on? What is time? I'll be making money through 4, I guess, sponsorships and whatever kind of capacity that may be. I have turned down literally all of them, but someday I'd like to. Yeah, I have a couple companies that I'd actually like to reach out to, so I'm keeping that on the list for this year, even though the likelihood's maybe not as high as in the coming years. 5, novels or novellas or short stories that I'll publish. So basically like fiction work. And then I gave myself this miscellaneous 6th category that is currently titled podcasts, but is like really just a filler space for optional future stuff that I have in mind, but are in the very beginning stages. Then it's time to fill this out for year 0, or like present day. For me, this means the year 2020. How much I'll have made in these categories, what pen names I'll have published under, with goals for how many copies sold, or like how many magazines or publications I've queried. Then I've tried to take this path of like most realistic growth. For example, like with YouTube, I'll probably make just under $10,000 this year before taxes, so we will have to keep that in mind. But for year 1 or 2021, my goal is to make 12,000. And then under one of the pen names that I hope to publish with this year, I want to sell 50 copies of my books. So the next year I bumped the goal up to 150 copies of my books sold. Let's chat specifics here though, because there are a lot of similarities to making videos as there are publishing books, at least for the self-pub world, and that your backlist helps you a lot. So the more books you have, the more videos that you have, the more money you'll be able to make. For instance, one of my like most viral videos that I tried writing like Stephen King one, I published it over a year ago, but in the past week it basically was able to buy me a coffee. So the more of those videos you have, just all adding up, the more of those books you have, just all adding up, the more things people can randomly click on and find, the more money you'll make. This, however, is different than like the number of articles I query and get published in a journal or magazine or newspaper or whatever, where you're paid for that single publication just one time, unless you're able to get yourself a recurring gig. Though this is a goal that I included in later years, I think not until year three, or like, you know, a lot of time spent querying and publishing and kind of making a name for myself. So some amount of realism, or taking what I have now and then combining that with the amount of work I'll be putting in, is how I get everything.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is for someone who creates things as their sole income, i.e. like not also working for a company. It's difficult because though these estimates are done with realistic growth in mind, it's dependent on a lot of factors, like relying on YouTube for a chunk of your income. Who knows, theoretically, where YouTube could be in a year. Or I could get sick and not be able to write as much as I'm currently planning, and that would obviously change my outcome and my forecast and impact my income. But the other thing is that I haven't taken into account any kind of breakout success, which is another reason diversifying is so helpful, because if you have breakout success in one, there's likely to be a trickle effect in all of the others. Theoretically, in any of these six categories, mostly like five categories, but it's fine, I could do way better than expected. Another video could go sort of viral, or one of my books could be swept up in the Amazon algorithm. I could get two recurring gigs earlier than anticipated, and all of these will likely increase the others as a result. More people watching my videos means more subscribers, means more eyes on maybe my eventual Kate Capital books, or maybe more people who will help support me on Patreon. More recurring gigs means I can plug myself in different areas, I'll be more visible to other publications, I will have a bigger wealth of knowledge to share on YouTube, and so on and so forth. They all can just kind of bleed in together. Now, there are a few things that really stood out to me while I was doing this three-year planning. One, I'd written down this goal to make as much from my creative endeavors as I was making at my full-time corporate job, and I wanted to do that by the time I was 30, but based on my estimates, it will be 31. Still though, that's pretty exciting. Two, the risk is sort of in my face all the time, but I also simultaneously feel really confident something might be broken, but I just really think that I can do it. Three, though I have this whole thing about read, write, roam, and a huge lifetime goal of getting paid to travel, I didn't really account for that anywhere in my like smaller planning and my income planning, or in the things I will need to do each year, month, day in order to make that goal a reality. So clearly there's a disconnect there. I have some ideas on how to remedy this, but I think it's something that I need to focus more brain power on. Yeah, I think that's it. Please do comment down below. Let me know how you plan. Let me know if you've noticed a disconnect between your big goals that you want to achieve and what you're sort of doing day to day, and how you're working to maybe fix that. But that is going to be it from me. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you especially to some of my new patrons this month. Laura Brecky, Lauren Holly, Erin, Emma Anstey, and Juliana. And I will see you all very soon with a new video. Bye!
I forgot something.
Then like the number. So some amount of realism accounting for, so some amount of realism at,